as I told you guys a few episodes back and a couple of days ago, the Power Beats Pro officially came out, and Apple announced it today, and, well, for the most part, I was pretty much right about everything I said in that video, so video's over! See you guys! Nah, I'm just playing, guys. Stay tuned, because I am going to break down everything that was discussed and everything that was talked about in this little press release that they did, and we'll get into it more, so stay tuned. Hey, what is up, everybody? Michael here. Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we're going to talk about a few things, but the main emphasis of today's video is the Power Beats Pro. I'm going to break down everything you need to know, and I'll also get in a little hint with a little Android news in there. So first up, as I told you guys, Apple unveiled the Power Beats Pro. And for the most part, the Power Beats Pro were pretty much exactly what I thought they were going to be, just wireless Power Beats. But there are a few things I did not know, so we're going to talk about it. So the first thing, the Power Beats Pro are, of course, Apple's truly wireless high-performance headphones that they are claiming. They're basically workout headphones. There's not much to say about this. They have up to 9 hours of listening time on each earbud, and the wireless charging case gives you 15 hours of additional minutes. It is sweat and water resistant, and it also has adjustable ear tips just like the Power Beats. Now, first thing you need to know is, since there are zero wires, obviously these are truly wireless. Now, everyone is saying these are the biggest competition to Apple's AirPods, but they're made exactly by Apple, huh? So, moving on. I don't know why they came up with that theory. So, first thing they talk about is the sound. They say that the Power Beats Pro deliver powerful, balanced sound with dynamic range and noise isolation. Now, one thing I will give Beats is, when they say noise isolation, I will tell you noise isolation is key. So far, I've been using the Galaxy Buds. A review on that should be coming out soon, but compared to the Beats, Beats definitely have a little bit better of noise isolation, but not terribly. But I will tell you though, Beats is great with isolating noise. Now, as for their sound, we all know Beats is there for the bass, but lately they've been changing the formula up, so it would be interesting to see how this stacks up. Who knows, maybe I'll buy them and try them out, who knows. Obviously, I may not keep them, but I will try them out for a review, possibly. Now, since these have Class 1 Bluetooth technology, you can go as far as you want. I don't think they will have Bluetooth 5.0, although there is a possibility it may, because the AirPods 2 have wireless capabilities of Bluetooth 5.0. I don't know what I was thinking of saying. But Class 1 Bluetooth, it probably should be 5.0. And as I already talked about, it is designed to be worked as workout headphones. Now, again, I told you there is a 9-hour battery life. It has quick charging, so 5 minutes of charge in the wireless charging case will give you up to an hour and a half use of these earbuds. Now, they do have the H1 chip, which allows you to use the little blank Siri, and you can use it. Now, if you are not a Apple user and you want to use these on Androids, thankfully they have physical buttons on the side, so you can use physical clicks. They also have sensors just like AirPods, so when they take out, they will detect if you've removed them. And there is the B button, which is always clickable. Then you come in four colors. They come in irony, black, moss, and navy. And the last thing you guys are probably gonna wanna know is the price. But before we talk about the price, I will say though, what you get in the box is kind of surprising. These will charge via lightning cable. So that is going to be the third Apple product that I know of where that charges via lightning. You now have the Beats X, the Beats Pill, and I believe this. So there will only be three. So it's kind of shocking to me that, and oh yeah, the Beats 3 with the lightning connector. Technically doesn't charge with lightning, but it has lightning port on it. So those are the only three Beats that you could pick up that use the lightning cable or use a lightning adapter to transmit the sound. So this is the third or fourth product to go with that, and I'm a little happy about that because at least you're not using micro USB, which I am not a big fan of. But then we get to the price, $249. Oh boy, oh boy. All right, I'm not gonna judge this right away because this, we don't even know when it's coming out. Some are saying it's gonna ship in May. If it ships in May, maybe I'll try it out, but I will tell you guys something. For $250, it's kind of a stretch, and I'll tell you why. Because you can get Apple's AirPods 2, which everyone does say is not the best. You could get them for $200. You could get the Galaxy Buds for $130, which again, review coming soon. And you could get other alternatives that are cheaper but may deliver in sound quality. You don't just have to buy Apple products. For me, I'm not a big fan of Beats. I only like the Studios 3. I don't like the Solos, and the Beats X I've kind of stopped using ever since I've used the Galaxy Buds. The only reason I use the Studios is when I work out or when I'm on the plane or anything. But other than that, I mean, truth be told, I'm not a big Beats fan. And the reason I'm not a big Beats fan is because that's all bass. Now, this is just my opinion. Of course, you guys may think differently. But for $249 to $250, that's quite a bit for a pair of wireless headphones. And if you guys don't know anything about Beats, everybody knows that Beats makes their stuff for like pennies. Like dollars even. Not even $10, $20. Like, a pair of Beats is made out of the cheapest materials, but it's the name and the look. That is how Beats is successful. They are known for the brand, and people just wear them all the time, and they just look stylish. Audio quality-wise, that's a whole other story. So look, I don't know how these will sound. They may be good. Look, who knows? Maybe they do cost a lot more to produce. But look, the track record with Beats, in my view, is just not good for me. I've learned since the Studios 3, and I honestly will not be buying any Beats products, but I may pick this up for a review, so bear with me on that. But honestly though, I can't tell you not to buy it because it's not out. However, there is a specific market for this headphone. It's mainly for people that work out and people that are just using for training. I like that. But I did say in my other episode, which I encourage you guys to check out, they should have just made a wireless, truly wireless version of the Beats earbuds. Those I would have probably have considered more than this, because those are in-ear, and also those sound pretty damn good for such a small thing. So for me, I would have preferred the Beats X or the Yearbeats 3 wireless, or the Yearbeats wireless. I get why probably Beats wanted to do this, but guys, Beats headphones cost pennies, and this is just probably one of them. I know that's how they make a profit, but they're making them for the lowest quality. However, you can argue with me on that, but if you want the facts, just look it up. It's all over the internet. You can literally see, even Dr. Dre said that their stuff is made out of garbage, but the only reason people are buying them is because of the name. So I'm not gonna stop you guys from buying these headphones. I'm not gonna stop you. Because they're not even now. So we're gonna have to hold all judgment on if they're a good pair or a bad pair. But just based on that price point, something just does not feel right for paying $250 for a pair of Beats. But with that said though, I am not ruling out that it is not recommendable. So please do not take my word and say do not buy them. Wait till they come out, listen to them yourself, and if you feel you're in that demographic for training, your workouts, then pick them up. But if you want something else, then just a pair of headphones, who knows, we'll see. So that's all about the Powerbeats Pro, and last story of the day, because I also want to include some stuff, is the Samsung Galaxy Note 10. So Samsung is considering releasing two versions of the Note 10. Yes, two versions. Not the Note 10 5G, the Note 10 E. So according to The Bill, which is very credible, they are saying that Samsung is considering releasing two versions of the Note 10, with the Note 10 E being in Europe. And to me, that is very, very bad, because the Note 10 is made for a very specific market. Those are high-class business people that need a business smartphone that can use a stylus, or just for people that really just want a bigger phone. But still, I don't think you need to release an E version of a big high-end phone. There are two different markets between the S10 and the Note 10, or the Note series or the Galaxy series. There are two different styles of people. You do not need to release that kind of product to kind of suit the needs of those for the Galaxies. If they wanted, they could just get a Galaxy. You don't need a Note 10e. So Samsung, please do not do this. Please. And that's it for today's show. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, hit the like button, hit the subscribe. Thank you guys so much for subscribing. I've been seeing a big increase in my audience. Thank you guys so much from the bottom of my heart for subscribing. And again, I am leaving the poll up as last week because you guys did not vote on my last poll, but it is still up and available if you do choose to vote. I will leave it up for this video, but please read the poll, vote it up, and let me know. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and peace.